Very good morning to all. Welcome you all. Welcome you for the meeting. Welcome you all the International Conference on Advances in Materials, Computing and Communication Technology, organized by our Anil Velamini College of Engineering. We consider that holding an international conference this year will give a new impulse to the normalization of the situation. Today's conference is about 350 groups of participants all over the world. We are experts from across the field sharing their thoughts, knowledge and opinions. Yes, one song can change a moment, one idea can change a world, one step can start a journey, but a prayer can change the impossible. Prayers are like songs composed by our hearts, desires, thoughts, emotions, etc. God enjoys listening our prayers and constantly answers through simple but significant miracles. Now, let us all stand for Tamil Thai Vaazhu by our AVZ choir.
Is the source of goodness, sign of light is the source of goodness, sign of happiness, and symbol of brightness which brings joy in everyone's life. Now let me know the dignitaries to light particularly as a sign of suffering.
Thank you, everyone. Small cheer, great welcome, makes a merry feast. It's our pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to you all. Your presence makes us very happy. Here's a hearty welcome, big and warm enough to encompass you all. Now, I request Dr. Anila Rose, Head of the Department of Science and Humanities, to deliver the welcome address.
Motivation towards success. Sir, I welcome you. Now it's my turn to welcome the chief guest of the day, the renowned finalist Sri Rajapandian of CTIS of ISRO Propulsion Complex, Mahendra Gill, who is blessed to make this conference and hear the memorable event. Sir, I welcome you on behalf of the organizing committee of this international conference and on behalf of our Anne Gelandani College of Engineering. Next, I would like to welcome Dr. Carlos Pena, Senior Professor, Institute of CMCS, UNICO, Applicators of Change, who is with us to give the first keynote address. Sir, hearty welcome to you on behalf of the organizing committee of our international conference and on behalf of our Anne Gelandani College of Engineering. Welcome you, sir. Now, it's my pleasure to welcome Dr. Anatoly Sadoviev, the CEO of Hayden Electric Welding Institute of Sydney. Sir, I welcome you on behalf of the organizing committee of the International Conference and on behalf of our Anne Gelandani College of Engineering. Now it's my duty to welcome Mylady Dr. S. Rajendran, Head of Research and Development, Tata Motors Industries Limited, Chennai. He is also the winner in order to make this conference successful. So I welcome you on behalf of our International Conference Committee as well as on behalf of our Anne Gelandani College of Engineering. Welcome you, sir. Now I welcome the chief patron, Mr. Praveen Deshras, for doing a very important part in this international conference. So I welcome you on behalf of the organizing committee and on behalf of the Anne Gelandani College of Engineering. Now I welcome our Vice Principal, Dr. Kathy Castro, who is one of the patrons of this international conference and who is also another driving force towards the success of our college and towards the success of our academic system. I welcome you, sir, on behalf of our International Conference Committee and on behalf of the Anne Gelandani College of Engineering. Now, I welcome the dignitaries and the peers for supporting. In order to make this day a wonderful one and make this conference a grand success, the city is here. Those who belong to our land are here with us. They take the strain to come over here in order to make this conference a grand success. Sir, I welcome you on behalf of the organizing committee of this international conference and on behalf of our Anne Gelandani College of Engineering and on my own behalf. Now I welcome our Director, our Admission Director, Mr. David Felix Daniel, who is here, who is the force behind every success of our colleagues, who does the work from one end to other, I can say. He will be a part and parcel of everything, every event, every success of our colleagues. So, I welcome you on behalf of the organizing committee of the International Conference and on behalf of the Anne Gelandani College of Engineering. Now I welcome all the scholars who are here and who are online to present their papers and to share their ideas and to grasp knowledge, whatever they are able to get through this conference. And I welcome each and everybody in order to gain knowledge, whatever you can, then whatever you can grasp through this conference and share your ideas, because this is the platform of knowledge. Here you have the possibility and you have the freedom to share your ideas, share your knowledge and grasp the ideas of others and clarify your doubts regarding your research as well as your wisdom. You are always welcome here. Now, the most important person of this international conference is here. He is the organizer, Dr. J. Sunil. He is the head of the Department of Mechanical Engineering and he runs NCMs to make this international conference successful. And it's because of you we are able to achieve this. Otherwise, it won't be possible for us to think of this event at all. So, now it's my duty and privilege to welcome him on all of our behalf. Welcome you, sir. Now I welcome the staff members of our college and the eminent scholars of teaching community and auditing community and the students community and even the persons who belong to industry and community to participate and utilize this opportunity in order to better themselves. Yes, nice. Welcome to you, one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. You are a good leader, even though you can talk to others, but then still call another. Now, I invite Dr. Benham, the principal of Anandavaranam College of Engineering, and president of the inaugural session of this international conference to deliver the president's program.
Beloved Chairman, Dr. Lee, Chief of this verse, Chief Guest, Raja Mandir, sir, Dr. Lee, Armand Barmal, sir, Dr. Anatoly, Dr. Carlos, My Lady Dr. Rajendra, sir, Vice Principal, Dr. Jayasim, Dean Research, Convener of this International Conference, Dr. D. Sunil, Associate Director, Manager, Teaching and Auditing Staff Members, Students, Delegates, a very good morning to you all. I am here to deliver the presentation address. You know the recent trend today. That is, everywhere we could find unemployment issue. Engineers are unemployed. Doctors are also unemployed. The reason behind this is weak networking. And you could find lot of doctor degree holders have applied for any jobs, any government jobs. You may have come across this worst scenario in newspapers and media. Lot of around 3,000 doctor degree holders have applied for a few positions in government institutions. So this is a very pathetic situation. The reason behind this is lack of networking and lack of passion. See, any student should identify this domain, this area of interest, where he could work for hours, the area where he could work for hours, his passion, his interest. Any student should identify that, any UG student. Then, that student should gain knowledge in that area. if he continues for PG, or if he or she is working, so he should work in that domain only. He should be thorough in the fundamentals. He should know the happenings in the present scenario. So to know these things, he should read journals, then magazines, and he or she should interact with professionals in that area. For that purpose, the conference will support. And in this pandemic situation, I am happy that we are organizing an international level conference in a grand manner, and this international conference will definitely provide a platform to share your findings, to know the recent happenings and networking. So you gain your knowledge and be an expert in your area through interaction, and definitely you will become employable and you will become tough. So when the situation is tough and the going gets tough, only the tough gets going. So keep this in mind and update your knowledge. And this conference, I definitely expect this will provide a super platform, wonderful platform to share your findings, and it will promote an opportunity for networking and interaction. I wish this international conference a grand success, and hereby I declare the conference open. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. All of the top personalities I know are lifelong learners, looking for new skills, insights and ideas. So, it's our honor to felicitate such great personalities present with us today. Now, record Sri is Radha Pandey, Priorities Instrumentation Systems, ISRO, Propulsion Complex, Mahendra Reed, to deliver the chief guest address. So please.
To solve this problem by creating intercoupled systems in supermatrices and self-assembled nanocomponents. So when we talk about new material development in graphene, the water material, the material of future always can be played. And in fact, a lot of research going on in the world in most of the leading academics as well as industries on graphene. And we also take up the graphene-based synthesize in a big way. The graphene pipe applications in multiple areas, like the graphene spin tonic, the ability to suspend polarized electrons to a non-magnetic channel, spanning between paramagnetic electrodes, to be exploited in future logic and memory storage devices, carbon nanomaterials, graphene and 2D nanomaterials. The graphene is a flat monolayer of carbon atom, tightly packed in two-dimensional honeycomb lattice. The BHA building block for graphene materials of all other dimensions. So when we talk graphene, we call it high-strength graphene. The strength of graphene is far, far superior to stainless steel. But the rest of it, for the thickness of the graphene, we have raised the 10 tons, it has a higher strength than the steel. And the graphene, like to let it lock, recognize potential to be transparent, conductive films to touchscreen and solar cells and other applications, replacing indium tin oxide, which is high cost of production. And also electrochemical energy storage devices like batteries and superconductors, like carbon solid use, offers a good opportunity where graphene takes over in this area also. For spectral applications also, graphene has shown to produce most defining and spectral effects in polymers, which are superior to carbon nanotubes, which the currently the technology is being used in carbon nanotechnology tube space. And the new materials development always has a role in additive manufacturing. So additive manufacturing has a properly known as a 3D printing, provides an opportunity for material innovation, but it's actually restricted to the narrow range of polymers and mostly defined by the manufacturer, machine manufacturers, what materials they use for this. But in future material research will focus on understanding how to control microstructures, shape, yield and residual structures in this family so that it finds a wider range of applications for the additive manufacturing. And additive manufacturing is going to be always going to be a different scale where we go for interplanetary and other missions where we take this manufacturing out of here, and we call it a space bound or on-orbit manufacture. Currently some technology research are going on-orbit manufacturing using additive technology. So what are the tools, components required for interplanetary missions? There it should be landing in summer planet, there it should be manufactured using additive technology. And when we talk about materials, the lightweight materials like aluminum and magnesium alloy, carbon, glass fiber, reinforced epoxy composite, metallic and composite foam, currently used in high value, car manufacturing, automobile manufacturing, soon find application in almost every car industries. And this gives the lightweight materials gives the advantages of lightweight, safety and crashworthiness. And also when our material is being talked about the sustainability of resources, like whenever we need, we discuss about material, the approach to circumvent the problems of materials that are difficult to dispose. But the disposal of materials after use finds a greater challenge to humans, and the material whose price is very strongly linked to limited natural supply, as well as the technical supply is vulnerable. It is like the material development is required to go for sustainable sources, which is based on biodegradable. That material should be biodegradable after use. Similarly, the material for energy, that the greatest challenge facing society in this century is the approach of clean, safe, secure and sustainable energy supply to provide a reasonable standard of living for the world's population. The material to meet these challenges are considered in terms of fossil fuel, nuclear power generation, renewable power generation, green energy and transmission. So green energy is going to dominate because of pollution and other hazards related to other fuels. And when we talk about the energy, naturally the development of superconductors finds a place. Superconductors has a very no electrical resistance, it will be a very low temperature, and already play a critical role in healthcare system like nuclear plant. These superconductors are based on niobium titanium or niobium tin and requires liquid helium temperatures for a clean, safe, secure and sustainable energy supply to provide a reasonable standard of living for the world's population. The material to meet these challenges are considered in terms of fossil fuel, nuclear power generation, renewable power generation, green energy and transmission. So green energy is going to dominate because of pollution and other related to other fuels. And when we talk about energy, naturally that development of superconductors finds a place. Superconductors has a very no electrical resistance, it will be a very low temperature. And already play a critical role in healthcare system like nuclear magnetic resonance. These superconductors are based on neodymium titanium or neodymium tin and requires liquid helium temperature for operation. So superconductors cables are being realized up to 600 meters length and demonstrated successfully for power transmission. They are able to manufacture much longer cables, high quality, and to offer a long-term cooling remains a critical challenge. Because cooling is the most concern when you use a superconductor. The key material development power electronics are the emergence of silicon carbide and gallium nitride at the most efficient high frequency power semiconductors, thermal management, packaging materials, including harsh environment, dielectric materials, high temperature solders, active cooling systems, dielectrics and other passives, as well as equipped chips in 3D arrangements of active and passive materials. And meta materials are artificial materials with electromagnetic properties that are difficult to achieve with naturally occurring materials. More of this, with single value permittivity and permittivity. The attack length of these meta materials should be several times smaller than that of the wavelength of instant electromagnetic wave. Meta materials are enabling technology for complex video manipulations that can be used to realize comfort of ultra low observability, near perfect absorption, cloaking, relatively small but very efficient antennas for deep space communication. And the biomaterials, they are growing like expectancy and rapid response in replacement and after surgery now demand their biomaterials implantable because nowadays a large number of hip, knee and other spinal joints are replaced almost in a routine basis. So this was for a material research where we get a implantable material. Generally when we talk about materials in terms of material informatics, the new area where self-adaptive materials and self-organized materials address probably the design of new materials using advanced algorithms, need for society to experience a constant scale of devices and proliferation of innovative materials. And nanoscale materials engineering and plasma enhanced light matter interaction shows to explore the real-time changes in material detail between 3D nanoscale activity with inexpensive, non-destructive, at the same time fast and accurate spectroscopy techniques are being evolved and to they are good experience nanomaterials synthesized and capitalized nanomaterials required for development of sensors, what we use in our testing, to measure pressure, temperature, flow level, research on synthesis of these nanomaterials being taken up in big way. And I just want to mention some few things like the materials behind nanomaterials synthesized, like piezoelectric nanomaterial, PCLT of 5 sub nanometers synthesized and use a sensing element to fabricate accelerometer, high-sensitive solar cell fabricated with zirconium oxide and platinum acid was given a efficiency of 3%. Aluminium nitride analogs with down to degrees Celsius, UV temperatures are being used for the pressure measurement at high temperature of the pressure. And there are different types of nanomaterials right now being pursued for development of sensors like constant based advanced nickel chromium alloy or isoelastic based nickel chromium, carbon, platinum tungsten for various measurements of pressure and strength. Copper, nickel, iron and rhodium for temperature, for mainly for thermocouple and RTD, barium titanate, zinc oxide, lead zirconate titanate, popular called TZT, lithium triborate are all being used in accelerometers and pressure sensor applications. These are nanomaterials now being synthesized and there are various synthesis methods like mechanical or vapor deposition in physical domain or the chemical methods, biological or hybrid methods using CVDs, micro-emulsions and rheolite polymers. The technology of nano is going to dominate in the near future. And electromaterials, the fabrication of quantum computers, new technology is like a manipulation of materials at the final stage. And much of the work exploits the presence of carbon molecules and carbon gauges, trapped atoms, nanotubes and graphene, which are other approaches rely on defects in silicon and other semiconductors, ion traps and photonics, with basic research in quantum photonics. Quantum photonics definitely finds a very big application in the future computing. Soft lithography, the ability to fabricate functional structures and working devices in different materials is central to the production of microelectronic devices, data storage systems and many other products The process is almost exclusively carried by highly surface, complex and very expensive for photolithography equipment happens in the controlled environment, in clean room. The microcontact printing has revolutionized many aspects of printing research. Molecules are transferred to a substrate using an allosomatic scan. The polyfilamental dimethyl siloxane or PDMS scan transforms to a substrate unlike hot mask using PDMS lithography. The impact of communication technology on surgical and private practice is one of the greatest components of the advanced in planning communication technology. It has simplified our life by providing them with the easiest and secure methods to work effectively and meet their required goals. The current issues and development of communications and information technology can assist all of us with the best features along with providing the supreme quality of work performance. As you all know that this type of conference is we previously never had this online, now it's feasible because of all this, always recommend later on, decide how to go about it. And the emerging computing technologies like data mining, AI, mobile computing, cloud computing and security, IoT, wireless sensor networks, digital image processing, neural networks, deep learning, natural language processing, and embedded systems are being developed in a big way, and these are technologies going to move. The emerging computing technologies like machine learning, the proliferation of cloud services, autonomous things like AI, drones and other technologies, software-defined wide-area networks, augmented analytics, methodologies which automate the insight utilizing AI and normal language term and without the commercial, it's not complete without 5G. 5G is coming in a very big way. 5G is a fifth generation cell phone communication following 4G, 3G and 2G framework.
Thank you. thanks to the introduction, Dr. Phil. Thank you for the American of the Thank you all for
and we are the habit and stayed on my environmental areas. Always try to see a biological which may go transducer that is generally electrical.
Silica or misopause alumina. Other material or nanomaterial are metal particles, such as noble metal particles such as gold, silver, or platinum. Organic polymers, especially those conductive properties such as polyol, polyalumin, polythiophan. And finally, carbon materials. Carbon materials, we find graphite, graphene, carbon nanotubes, carbon nanofibers, and nanohawks. In the case of nanoparticles, the most used are gold or platinum, but mostly those of gold. They have an advantage of having a high area to volume ratio. It can be functional or decorate. It has very good compatibility, and therefore they can be used as drug carriers. For example, the biosensor can be constructed with two nanomaterials, graphene and gold, and develop sensor capable to detecting mitochondrial DNA. Misopause materials, like gold nanoparticles, they have a large area to grow on the ratio. The misopause pulses they are a uniform symptom because they have the ability to act as nanoreactors. If an enzyme is included with them, this enzyme is protected from external attacks and can better perform its function. They can also be functional and attached to the electrode surface. The better for me is the carbon nanotubes. Carbon nanotubes are well known and widely used because they have an advantage of being very good conductors. They are very small, which is a large temperature change. And the downside is that they are a bit expensive. Like the other materials already mentioned, they can be functionalized and development of sensors. Some and tubes now have a structure similar to a cone or horn, which is why there are carbon nanohorns. They have not been much investigated, but they have the particularity that when they are suspended in some liquids, they adopt the propagate into flower in the center can retain some molecules of biological interest. The materials that I most want are magnetic particles, from they can be functional. They can be easily retained on the surface and they will try using a neodymium magnet. To finalize, a very promising material in the development of biosensors is the graphene, which is not other than dysmethylene graphene, is a polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbon of infinite theoretical expansion and is very good conductor to electricity. It can be used as good electron transducer phase. Finally, what is the development of these devices to the more and better? In many places, but in my opinion, one of the best centers is the University of California in San Diego with Professor Joe Grant. Professor Joe Grant has a center that develops wearable sensors. In this way, biological parameters can be monitored in real time, both in healthy and sick people. For the future, your time biosensor, we need to increase the stability. It is necessary to develop new materials or to improve the materials that allow compatibility with the biological molecules of the sensor. They will be very useful in the development of a new better immunosensor, such as those used in the detection of SARS-CoV-2. And finally, something that will be the job of nanoengineering specialists to develop better biological recognition molecules in order to not go to the hospital. The idea is that this device can be used by anyone, everywhere. Thank you very much for the invitation and for your invitation, Dr. Sun.
For sharing your innovative ideas, positive thoughts, and encouraging words. Thank you. If your actions inspire others to dream more, you are a leader. I'm happy to invite Dr. Arumuga Perumal, NIT, Karnataka, India, to give the keynote address. Sir, please.
Good morning. Respected Chairman Dr. Peter Jesus, respected Vice Chairman, then Chief Guest, P.S. Rajapandian, Scientist, ASRO, then respected Principal, Dr. A. Benham, then respected Vice Principal, then respected HOD Mechanical Engineering and other teaching and non-faculty members of AMI and Vela Kennedy College of Engineering, then researchers, students, dignitaries, and everyone. Okay, good morning. Today I am going to discuss about various computing techniques related to the conference. A student is visiting the laboratory and conducting experiment, it really takes time. And a student wants to do means analytically, even it requires more time. Better what he can do computational technique to solve any flow problem. He can concentrate, means modeling software, and he can use any computing technique related to his domain. Even you can see many research papers and many researchers working in the area of computing technique. Even according to new education policy 2020 introduced by Government of India, it encourages students to do means interdisciplinary work and intradisciplinary work related to academics. Even I strongly encourage researchers to use different computing techniques in our engineering domain. Today you can see many industry want to solve their open problems by engineers. Even there is a gap between academics, academia and industry. Even we require a strong curriculum to meet industrial needs. It is the student duty to concentrate some particular domain related to his research, and he should study in depth, then only he can gain more knowledge. Even today's situation, that COVID-19 situation, student conducting and the same way going to institute and all is really very difficult. Better he can concentrate on means computing technique. It is very simple. He can use his laptop or computer. He can sit in his home. He can solve many real-time problems. Even you can see, means nowadays very, very challenging problems. All are using computer or laptop or any software, and they are trying to find exact solutions. Many methods, you can see finite difference method, finite volume method, like lattice Boltzmann method, many numerical methods. Nowadays, not only undergraduate students, postgraduate, PhD students, all are working towards same way some computational solutions. Even you can see in today's world, the student should concentrate not only his curriculum or his subject, it is his duty to concentrate research also. Now, the faculties also, even not only teaching, all are doing teaching and research. Even you see many premier institutions, people are working towards means industrial needs and many work related to that is computational solutions. You can see nowadays that computing technique not only means a major domain. People are working for small component also. Even not only you can use fluid, even you can use gas also to study the problem, and you can find exact solution. Suppose you see here several methods, several industrial need related to energy and the same way computing. Even people use several computing techniques, they always divide the domain into small problems, and they use parallel computing technique also to find out the solution. Even you can see here nowadays multiple entry, multiple exit as per same way new education policy 2020. A student can join some engineering like mechanical engineering. Then even he can do minor in same way ECE or computer science, suppose if he did not get opportunity to join in that branch. Even a student want to do some interdisciplinary work or intradisciplinary work, even he can collaborate with the other university, not only in India, in abroad university also, even he can do, he can produce research. Even nowadays, many undergraduate students, they do internship at same way industry, and they are trying to solve many problems. To know those things, it is your duty to strengthen your computing technique knowledge. Even several techniques are there, like the finite volume method, finite difference method, lattice Boltzmann method. Even a set of points is connected together by links is called lattice, and it is coming from Boltzmann equation. That is why this method is called lattice Boltzmann method. This kind of numerical method, even we study numerical method is a subject in engineering curriculum. It is your duty to concentrate that subject, and you should find out the
solution.
You see the topic advances in materials, same way computing and communication technologies. It is your duty to relate same way materials and same way computing and communication technology. If you are well and good, you can combine all three, you can produce many results. Even I encourage young students to work in different field, okay, in different engineering field, even real-time field, okay, even they can use their computer or laptop, even people are now using cell phone also to find out the solution. Compared with the analytical study or experimental study in today's scenario is really difficult. Even people use several computing techniques to find out the exact solution. Even you can go for some small domain also like micro channel or microchip. Even in laboratory many equipments are there. Even you can use air as a working fluid or water as a working fluid. Suppose you see here fluid mechanics laboratory. Even we do experiments, nowadays no one is doing experiments there, we are conducting online fluid mechanics laboratory. Students is sitting in his home, even he is doing fluid mechanical experiments, same way using software, even he can get the same solutions. I strongly encourage organizers to concentrate on this field. Even today, it is the researcher's duty to go through, and all topics related to this conference is really wonderful. And I thank organizer for conducting such a wonderful conference. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your suggestion of encouraging the interdisciplinary and intradisciplinary research to face the present competing world and to overcome the hurdles of education. Thank you, sir. The ability to scrutinize others is called being critical. The ability to scrutinize oneself and change, that's called wisdom. Now, I call upon Dr. Anatoly Sadovy, EO Pattern Electric Welding Institute, Ukraine, for the keynote address.
Welcome.
Skill wise, lower lowering or higher lowering skill wise. So, using computational technologies and some different algorithms, we can prognose and propose optimal modes of welding and create sound structures. Why it is needed? This is needed to make some structures of high quality. And of course, there is some problems of material science here, especially relation between structure and property. When we create some material or some structure from metal material, the properties of such metal will be depend from structure. And when we programming and proposing some optimal welding modes, we can govern structure of material and thus property. So, dear colleagues, I am really happy to be one of participants, and I am thank you to organizing committee and Dr. Sanyu for kind invitation. And I wish you very good proceeding and good achievements and collaboration and connection. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot for your thought-provoking words. Thank you. If you are working on something that you really care about, you don't have to be pushed. Now, I invite my lady, Dr. S. Rajathurai, Head of Research and Department, Sharda Motor Industries Limited, Chennai, to give the keynote address. Sir, please.
Good morning to all of you. I am unable to present. Is that an option I have given? Can you open the presentation window?
Sir, kindly use audio. Sir, kindly use audio.
No. Okay, sure.
Thank you, sir.
So, good morning to all of you. It's a great pleasure, and I sincerely thank the administration of Anna Venamani College of Engineering, Kanyakumari University, South India, for organizing such an international conference and allowing us to do a presentation. My topic of discussion is smart manufacturing in automobile exhaust system. Exhaust system, as you know, is a device
used. Gases in a cleaner, quieter, and safer way to the atmosphere. While it is doing its job, diesel and gasoline vehicles have different temperatures, so the materials used in the exhaust system is very critical for the safety of the vehicle as well as the safety of the passenger. I'm going to take two examples. One is material sensitization. Why it's important for manufacturing yield, and also one of the computational simulation, as the last speaker talked, how the computational simulation can do a virtual drawing of codes for this particular automobile application. As you know, sensitization is a process that is used to, when during the welding process, if the welding process increase the temperature more than 700 degrees, chromium rich material has a tendency to migrate and carbide will be precipitating if there is carbon in the, it is also the carbon inherently present in steel, as well as it can be a carbon in the impurity, oil, particles or anything. So that gives sensitization. So if the sensitization is more than 8, I am unable to show the screen, but if it is more than 8, it is resistant to sensitization. And today, conventionally, 4 types of materials are used in the exhaust system. One is aluminized steel, which is not preferred now for the BS6 applications. The second batch of examples are SUS, stainless steel 409, 410 and 410L. Those are a bucket of materials which can be used where the chromium is less. The next batch of material is SUS 425, 436, 439 and 441. Those materials are about 18% chromium. The next batch is SUS 304, SUS 310 and SUS 316. So these are 4 batches of materials can be used for exhaust system, while the third and fourth batches has more chromium and it is required now for the BS6 applications for the urea injection and all. So what is important is that how you are going to care about the carbide formation, how do you avoid carbide formation, which is the life risk of the part. So sensitization process, in order to do it, you have to be welding the part slightly lower than 700 degrees centigrade. For that, there are different welding processes are available, like you have DC weld, pulse weld, like cold material transfer weld, and also we have micro-MIG weld. So in the robotic welding, in most of the processes are now robotic. So in the robotic welding, we have preferred micro-MIG process so that the temperature will be about 634, it's slightly lower than 700 degrees, that carbide cannot be formed. If the carbide can be avoided, then your lifetime of the vehicle as well as the child parts components is longer. The next one, I'm talking about the cone drawing. In a deep drawing cone, it's the same way stainless steel 409 can be used, 439 can be used, or 304 can be used. But the dependency of this drawing procedure will be more on the physical properties like elongation, hardness. If the elongation is more, it is likely to have a better yield on the productivity of the products. As well, if the hardness is lower, hardness has to be there, there is no choice for a stainless steel. But if the hardness is in the range of 130 instead of 119, then it will give you roughness, that it will not be able, it will be ductile property, it will crack. If the drawing is easier, then the elongation property should be higher and the hardness should be lower. We have also simulated computationally the deep draw process. Usually the cone is drawn with a pre-blank, first draw, second draw, outer trim, piercing and extrusion and flange forming. In all these steps, we have different yields and that we cover it in order to make sure that the material properties are giving better yield and better productivity. We have, I have slides on the drawing, cone drawing simulations, which is correlated with the manufacturing process. Unfortunately, I could not share now, but I will be definitely sharing to the students of the university later on. And we have oblique cone, eccentric round cone, oblique elliptical cone, straight round cone, straight elliptical, several different cones. We have calculated the yield as well as the allowable thinning of the cone. Finally, the automotive components durability increases as sensitization resistance increases. Deep draw cones give maximum yield and productivity with increase in elongation and decrease in material hardness. virtual cone drawing by computational simulation increases productivity and cost reduction. Extensive use of robotics in manufacturing, computational simulation in manufacturing, and cross-industry partnership and collaborations will propel the growth of manufacturing markets. Productivity, yield improvement, quality and safety can all be increased through smart manufacturing. Smart manufacturing techniques provide innovative and premier exhaust system in global automotive markets. Smart manufacturing is not the end, it is just the beginning. The future is for artificial intelligence. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for sharing your views on materials sensitization and safety measures to be followed to maintain our vehicles, which are of your very use. Thank you so much, sir. Now is the time for paper presentation session. So, participants, you can continue, be in the link, and you can proceed.